So we're called to order the select board meeting of April 2nd. Now we bring up the agenda. Which saves me. Okay, so approval of the March 26th minutes, any comments? Are we ready to say they're okay? All right.
Did you want to?
By consensus.
I thought I saw a note saying that you were going to put a dollar on it.
I got it, I got it, did get it. Yes, Andrea sent it today, so you've got that in there?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll make a motion to accept?
We can just do it, as long as we, as long as we say we're okay, which is why I check in, make sure there's no comment or whatever, we can do it that way. All right, community input, I see a few people here, Mr. Desch?
Sure. Joe Desch, 22 River Road. I'm actually here representing the Woodland Association. One of the things that the association wanted to do was to spend some money to clean up the entranceway into the development. As you drive down the street on either side, it's pretty wooded, a lot of trees overhanging the ditches and stuff, so we wanted to spend the money on it to take care of that. I noticed that this is town property, so I didn't want to go ahead, you know, we're dealing with licensed tree people, but I didn't want to go ahead and have that work done without checking with the town. I'm not sure if it's the select board that I deal with or just pass through the ideas that we're trying to do, or somebody else in town I should speak to.
I think we're the board.
Okay.
So that's appropriate. Do you have like a plan or some ideas that you can share with us?
Well, I can get more detail on it. I mean, this is, just so you know, the piece of land that we're talking about. This is, it's pretty much these are the two.
Where's the entry?
Coming in here.
Oh, okay.
And then down here, so this is her, Eva's house here.
Oh, yeah.
And then, so they're not that deep, but, you know, obviously they do butt up against these people's property and stuff. And the plan is, and I can put this in writing if you want, but the plan is really just to go about, you know, there are those swales at the edge of the road. Was really to go back 10 feet, just thin out, there's a lot of saplings, a lot of dead trees, a lot of things over, and it's really more aesthetic than anything else.
Yep.
With it. But that's what.
So if you can give us just a better idea of what you want to do, we'd have our road agent take a look at it to make sure
okay.
that there's no impact, mm-hmm. and that you're only affecting property that is the town's.
Right.
I know our prior road agent, you know, said that this is so shady, and the fact that it's so shady leads to some difficulty with the road not drying out.
Drying out and stuff, yeah. I mean, yeah, this part of the road is quite, especially about here, it's quite a mess as far as the pothole. But, and I know that's a different thing that's getting fixed. But do you want me to just recap something in an email? And
it doesn't have to be detailed. Yes, you could include just, what is your alias, road?
Road agent.
Road agent.
Road agent. So that should be out on the website also?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And, you know, approximately when, you know, when you think you would want to do it. Because we're also, this is the area that we're hoping to resurface.
Yes.
So we don't want to get in one another's way.
Right.
So it might be better before,
before. It's going to be kind of mild. If you look, when you look at it, it's mostly like, you know, 2-inch saplings that are
just really
covering.
Really just clearing,
It's very just cosmetic in the sense that it's not a clear cut back 10 feet, and that it's most of the larger trees will stay. There's some standing dead trees. We'll have the guys take out that. I think people want to just have it look a little bit nicer, and they want to spend some money to take care of it.
And Joe, if you could also let us know that this is on behalf of the association, it's not you personally, but you know, so that all of that is a matter of public
record. Okay, so I'll send it to the road
agent
and to the select
board. Yeah, select board. Yeah.
And you want me to include this in just for clarity? Or?
Yes. Just included in the public records. So.
Great. All right.
Thank you
very
much.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Any other community input, Al?
I was just curious about the standing on the Conservation Commission.
Yes, of course.
I know there's a couple of emails we sent back and forth last year, this year. I've answered your emails. It was about Herb Uyeder, evidently.
Well,
at one point was going to get on, and he said he couldn't do it if work had changed.
Correct.
So
what happened? So we straightened things out in 2016, I think. We had some issues, we straightened them out. 2017, we started the process, we checked in with you, and I said that you were expiring, there were a couple of people expiring.
Yeah, right.
And so
Salton and Robin.
So you never came back to say that you wanted to continue, or Robin wanted to continue.
Yeah, I assumed that was.
Well, you can't assume that, Al. We don't assume that, right? So I wrote again in January and said, we actually have.
And I wrote back to you.
Yes, I can tell you what our conversation was, actually. Well, I do apologize for not getting in touch with you personally, which is what I was going to do when I've been caught up, so I'm really sorry about that. Let me see what I can find this here. What's that?
Editing red?
Just put it this way.
Yeah, first I have to find it, I'm not sure. So. Sorry, so here was the message I sent in January. Looks like the board never made 2017 appointments to the Conservation Commission. I've searched the minutes of the March town meeting through the end of May of 2017, and found the following two items. On March 20th, I said I would talk with the chair, Al Dyan, regarding appointments. The CC has not yet submitted recommendations. On March 27th of 17, I relayed your tentative recommendations that Lorraine Hansen be appointed as a full member and Herb Ueda be appointed either full or alternate. And that's all I found. So I never, there was never a response about you, about Robin.
I thought I came in and talked to you about it, but what
there was nothing in the minutes.
Lorraine said she wanted to stay on as an alternate.
Yeah.
And Herb said he couldn't do it.
Yeah.
And I said, basically, we have what we have is would have been myself, Robin Aikman, and Dan.
Marquis.
That
was, I don't believe we had that conversation. It's not in the minutes. There's no email. So, you know, and I admit that we also didn't get back to you again, but I was hoping, as chair, that you would have
helped us. I got this email last year, and I definitely sent you the email that Lorraine wanted to stay as an alternate, and I also said that Marquis, I don't know, at the time we were talking about Marquis becoming an alternate, but it doesn't really matter one way or another. But anyways, I know at one point I said that it was myself was up, and Robin was up, and Marquis was up, and Lorraine was going to stay on as an alternate, and Ueda was out because he said he just couldn't do it because of his work schedule. So that's,
well,
and I mean, I've been chairman, I mean, I've been, holding meetings and stuff since then, so.
Well, I agree that we dropped the ball because we never get back to you and said, hey, look, Al, you're still in an unexpired term. Robin Aikman is in an unexpired term. So I continued in the January email. I said, that's all I found, at least through May. As you know, it's difficult for a board like this to stay on track, so I apologize for our role in not following up. Did we do something after May 31st to appoint members? If so, can you please give me an idea of when we did this? If not, we'll need to get this squared away for 2018. We'd like to hear from you and the commission regarding what you think the current makeup of the commission is and who is looking to stay on in 2018. From a procedural standpoint, here is what I have. This would change if you can let me know when the board might have appointed 2017 members. So I have Robin Aikman, Dan Marquis, and you serving in unappointed terms. Mm-hmm. They expired at the town meeting in 2017. Mark Kuchar and Tamara Nijakowski's term are expiring in May and March of 2018. The website and the committee folders reflect the same. We really appreciate your help. You're helping us to straighten this out. And your response was, it turned out Ueda said his job did not allow him enough time to be on the board, and Lorraine wanted to stay on as an alternate. So there was nothing about that you wanted to say, that Robin wanted to say, that anybody wanted to say.
I just assumed that was going to be the case. I mean,
I'm sorry.
Maybe we all screwed up. I don't know. Are you trying to say I'm not on the board anymore?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Have fun.
Well,
I'll give you my, whoever you want to put in there. give them the books and go from there.
You can bring them into town. You can give them to Caroline. I don't know who's going to, we don't know who's going to be the chair.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah, thank you all. Appreciate it.
Great town we got now, you know that? Love it.
All right. Let's continue on. I'm sorry I didn't check in with him personally, but I have a lot of things to do. All right. Get to the agenda. Department heads, I see.
I got plenty. I got a lot you might want to go.
You've got non-public, Dr. George, too, so.
I have two non-publics, so.
Get one again.
Good evening.
Hello. Okay.
We need to make some repairs to some of the blue lights on Cruiser 71. So purchase order number 1371, made out to Two-Way Communications, for the amount of $250 to repair emergency blue lights on Cruiser 71. That'll come out of our maintenance. Albert, where do you repair from?
Purchase order number 1371, Two-Way Communications, for $250.
Second.
Any questions, discussions? All those in favor say aye.
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 Item number two, we'd like to purchase 53 Deer t-shirts for the kids in the 5th and 6th grade. So we have purchase order number 1370, made out to DareCatalog.com, for 53 Deer t-shirts for $344.50, and that will come out of our Deer line item.
Purchase order 1370 for Deer Catalog for 53 Deer t-shirts for kids, $344.50.
So there's a motion, second. Any questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
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 Okay, the fire department recently changed the frequencies with Dover. And now as a result of that, we have no communication with Dover Fire, Rollinsford Fire, and neither does the highway department. I received a quote from Two-Way to reprogram all of our police radios and all the highway radios so that we would have the current fire frequency, and they said no more than $450. And the fire chief did send me an email saying that he would pay for the cost to have that done. If something happens, he's not able to do that, I can find money in my radio repair account to take care of that. So between one of us, we take care of that. So I purchased order number 1372, made of Two-Way Communications, to reprogram all police and highway department radios with the new fire frequency.
There's no way, huh? All right, I'll move purchase order number 1372 to Two-Way Communications for up to $450.
Second.
All right, I have a question. So what could we have done to have thought about this ahead of time? Where did the process break down?
I don't want to blame the city of Dover, but certainly, you know, if the Dover's changing their frequency and Rawlinson's going to stay on that frequency, meaning the fire department, then I guess it would have been nice if someone from our fire department had told us a little bit sooner.
Yeah.
So, by the way, on this day we're swapping over, because the day that Two-Way was here to do all the fire department radios, I mean, we could have had our vehicles here at the exact same time, and it probably would have been a little less expensive for them.
Yeah.
Just do it all at once.
So maybe a lesson for the board is when these kinds of things come up that we should ask, does this have an impact on anybody else in the town? And we didn't ask that, and so this happened.
And you shouldn't have asked that. You know, it should be upon the department heads. You know, if I'm doing something I know is going to affect somebody else, wait a minute, I have to think here. So.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, well, ready to call the question? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I'm going to put RFD, and you'll just kind of straighten it out.
Okay.
Okay, and the last item I have is the pay rate. Those are my recommendations based upon the,
Is there just one copy?
Do you want to,
Could you make two others, and then I'll look at them at the same time, if that'd be helpful.
Is the fire chief coming in tonight doing that?
I'm always as surprised as the rest of us.
I didn't know, and anyone said anything.
I know, it's their monthly meeting night, that's all I know.
Because if,
Did reply to my email though. Pardon? He did reply to my email that he would talk about it tonight.
Okay. I was wondering if South Berwick has an issue in your opinion.
I asked that question on the email, and it's all right there. All mutually.
I didn't do that.
Because I had someone who was doing it, doing it in their station. It's quiet in my house for like 3 days.
We had to get ours done up.
All right, so I don't want to talk about it until everybody has a copy.
I will.
I apologize. Thank you, Caroline. All right, so let's just kind of go through, make sure we understand what we're seeing. So these are the, your recommended salary changes.
Correct.
And they stay within the 3% salary base increase that we provided to the, to you.
Well, within 3%, yeah.
Excellent. So, Officer D. Pasquale doesn't get any because he's not, wasn't here long enough, is that correct?
We'll reevaluate him in March.
So, 3% we had already put on your line, and you're the only one there, so that one is easy. This is all public information, right?
Yeah.
So, Officer Hancock, 3%. And so just so that I understand, the increase is on their regular pay.
Correct.
And their overtime would also reflect that. We don't know what it is, so is that...
No, Caroline has the figures there on the far right. What it boosts their overtime rate to and what they're due.
All right, very good. So, and then Officer LaJoy, 2%, Officer Stevens, 2%, this is Lieutenant Maskovich. Sergeant Stevens. Sergeant Stevens.
Is it all based on merit?
Yes.
And part-time?
Some.
But again, there was sufficient...
Oh, it doesn't have percentage, it just says NA.
No.
All right, so let's change it.
Layton?
Yep.
3.
3%?
2%, that came up to, well...
The dollar is...
Okay, it says 4 cents.
I just didn't have...
It says 4 cents, there we go.
Oh, okay.
It is 4 cents.
Okay.
It is there, yeah.
Oh, okay, this is no rate.
Just not the percentage.
So 4 cents for Officer Layton, Officer Philbrook, and what, so detail 4 cents, 6 cents for regular part-time, our animal control person 4 cents, okay. So everybody's here and accounted for.
Everybody's there and accounted for, yes.
All right. So I would look for a motion then to accept the police employee pay rates as presented by Chief Ducharme.
I'll make that motion.
I second.
Any questions? Do you want to talk about this more?
No, it's merit basis, and she saw it on work on that.
Okay. All right, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I will sign it. Caroline, if you could scan this and the other one so that I
sent
see
the other
it.
One.
Did you send it to me?
Just today, yes.
Oh, okay.
But yes, I'll scan that also.
Because I also want to update the Municipal Association, their salary schedules. They like to keep up with this, and I know we didn't do any last year, so it would be good. I guess we'll just give that to Caroline. I will thank you for doing that.
She put it together.
Thank you for doing that.
Mm-hmm. The numbers, she put it in a nice spreadsheet for you.
Excellent. Love it. Love the data.
That's all I have for you folks. Anything for me?
How did we make out with the water main this morning? Did they get it fixed again? Maybe that's where they're already here, so.
When I went home, they were still out there, so.
I came home a different way, so.
Yeah.
Was it our water main? Was it our folks that were doing it, or was it
Dover?
Dover.
It's not fixed.
It's not fixed.
It's on Oak.
Jude's water.
Rollins.
Rollins, Oak Street.
It was in Rollins.
Somebody fixed it before the night, so.
Well, we didn't lose any water.
Well, they said you could lose water on our street, so maybe they didn't have to, I don't know.
I think it was that far.
Alright, I think we're good.
We're good.
Thank you. You going to opening game, the opening day?
Yes, definitely.
Alright, have fun.
You can wait till tomorrow, as long as I get the.
That's why I just want a copy.
Alright, that's.
Alright, tomorrow.
Oh, Chief Rutherford. Oh, no.
Yeah, I'll be going to non-public, so.
Huh?
You don't want to spend the night yet.
Are they gonna anyway?
No.
Our other two department heads both have non-public to discuss, so.
Oh, okay. I don't have any.
I never heard back, I remember you had sent it to Elizabeth.
Strahan?
The template you wanted to use for.
Yes.
Was that okay by her? I never heard back with that.
I don't know that I officially heard back, but maybe,
There it is.
Wow.
Either use it or not, that's your first one right there.
Wow. Chief Rutherford, you know how to bring a smile to my face, woo-hoo! Alright, so just so everybody knows what this is, with our Derek grant, we just submitted the final paperwork, by the way, last week, and it was a little bit of a da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, but we did it.
Yeah, I got all your emails.
Yeah, I know, woo!
Rounded it up for you, yeah.
Yeah, all of a sudden, it got to be the, sort of like the bitter end. But, so we got it in, so we're now anticipating receiving the check. I don't know how soon after the final report or anything, but whether it has to go back through government council, I'm not at all sure, but anyway, it's in the works, we should be getting almost 10,000. Sometime in the next, I would say, 46 weeks. Associated with the grant, though, grants always have terms and conditions and deliverables, and so we have to continue to report to them on a quarterly basis for 1 year, or is it 1 year? And then on an annual basis.
Two years.
Two basis,
or annual
after that. Okay, so 2 years of quarterly, 1 year, and then 2 or 3 years of annual. So I've created templates for Chief Rutherford to use, and he's used it, and I'm delighted. So I'll let you look at it, and then if you have no, what we're reporting on is the amount of fuel used, the number of miles used, this is on the new machine, and the estimated amount of idling. So that's the.
Yeah, because this is the actual provisions that we have to follow on.
Oh, okay.
And then you can see right here, they're highlighted black, within 15 days after the quarter, that needs to be submitted. So we're ahead of the curve right there.
So Mark, there's a folder. Did you take this off the folder? Because I have a folder with all the things when they're due. Maybe Caroline can show you.
Somebody forwarded it to me and I just copied it all off.
Okay, alright.
So the idle time is when you're at it, when you're working with it and it's running idle.
That is the one thing that's pretty much an estimate, because.
It's not working time, it's idling time when it's.
Yeah, like if you go to a call and you sit in the call for an hour.
Yeah, okay.
It's not being driven.
But it's using, you know, it's.
Yeah, it's running, but it's not being.
It's kind of a guesstimate end of that, and we're doing that off of engine hours, we'll hit the engine hours and we have an idea how much time we've actually driven it. Because there's a fair amount of miles there just because of driver training to get people up and training. But I mean, you could go to a call, mutual aid someplace, and it sits there and idles. Well, it did the other night, we went to South Berwick, up way out in the boobies, and it sat there for like 2.5 hours just idling.
You know, I'm sure that it's used for data, and not just for the state of New Hampshire, but just like nationally, to show the effectiveness of the Derek grant, for example. So they would compare how much would be spewing into the atmosphere with this amount of idling and miles driven in an older machine and versus this newer machine. All right, so I'm going to sign the quarterly report. So Caroline, can you scan and put it in the Derek folder and give it to me, and I'll put it, and then we'll send it. Caroline, you can send it right to Liz.
Yes.
That's just excellent.
Every now and then, something.
I would say. probably betting higher than that.
One purchase order for you this evening.
Okay.
So $1,338, and it's to Larry Straffen, who is the lead instructor for the firefighter 1 and 2 course that I explained. We have 3 members in. Let's see, we're beginning in April. They're going to get done in June. So I'm putting in the PO for it. And for the 3 individuals, there's 2 that are going to complete firefighter 1 and 1 that's going to complete. Actually, they're all going to get firefighter 2 because it's a 1 and a 2 program. One of the members already has his 1, but he hadn't finished his 2. So he's doing the whole thing again as a refresher. So basically, we have 3 guys that are going through the class, and it's the 1 and 2, a total of 1950. For those individuals, and they're all doing very well because I track them. I talked to Larry Straffen. He's the assistant chief in North Berwick, and he's the one that's the course coordinator. There's 22 people in the class. Actually, I got another new guy.
One new guy?
Yeah, he just came through the door. He's looking for a class. We got to try to find another one. Of course, the timing wasn't right. We could get him in this one, but we'll find him a class.
Okay. I move first order number 1338. To Larry Straffen for $1,950.
Second. What's that? Okay.
Somebody has to say to spell the name.
Oh, yes, yeah, I'll hand it off to you. Okay. Any comments or questions? So I do have one. So is this one of the trainings where they are either paying half or they have to commit to staying on? What is the...
We have a form. They don't stay on after they get their certificate, their permanent certificate. They have to stay on the farm for a year. If they don't stay for the year, they're going to pay half the money back.
Okay. All right.
That's their commitment to us investing in them.
All righty. I will call the question. All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. Just that the police all of a sudden weren't able to communicate.
That's correct. Neither were we for 2 days. That goes to somebody other than
me. I don't know. It's like, right, you'll have to learn with Caroline. I just
paper.
I hand it off to you.
But Bob pulls them back.
Bob pulls them back, and I don't know what happens to the others. But
this has my voice.
The whole radio thing has been one big pain.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been one severe lack of communication between Dover Dispatch, Dover Fire Department, two-way communication, to the point where last Monday night I talked to dispatch precisely to say, when is this going to happen? And I talked to 3 different dispatchers and none of them had a clue. And how they could be working in that agency and not know when they're going to flick the switch is still beyond me. The next day they flicked the switch at like noontime. We found out about it at like 6 in the evening. And I explained this before, they're on their digital side. They're still using our frequency. I've already pounded on them. If you're going to use our frequency for 3 months, then maybe we should adjust what our cost is going to be. Because we're still on the analog side.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way they can set off their house phones to their 3 fire stations is by using our frequency to do that. Until their digital is up and running, which is still 2 months away on that part of it. So basically what happens is you can hear Dover tone out over us, and you'll hear it, you'll hear the house tones, and it'll say, truck 1, and the ambulance goes somewhere. And then that's all you hear. You never hear any other communication. So that's kind of it. So they're on our system at the same time. The other issues is, and I know I got an email from the chief, and he was asking me, we had a meeting 6 months ago. Six months ago, and then 6 weeks ago, Bill Bartlett, who's the CEO, whatever, two-way, and it's in our minutes that we keep, that they were supposed to do the police when they did fire.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously that did not happen. I talked to an officer, a call we had the other day, and even his officers did not know that they didn't, that this had happened. This happened Tuesday, and I talked to an officer on Saturday, and he didn't even know.
So, but I believe, we just signed a purchase order tonight for two-way, so that will straighten out.
Yep.
The police and the highway, is our understanding. Is everyone else, is there anyone else, like South Berwick and York and Michaels?
Here's a copy of the letter which was drafted and sent to all area fire departments. I have since done another one through the Seacoast Chiefs, which was distributed 10 days ago. And that's kind of a joint effort between Dover and us to explain what is happening. And it kind of gives you the frequencies and whatnot. And then I sent out a separate one just on the Rollinsford Fire headline so that it would go to the chiefs as a backup. Because you can see we're kind of on the bottom of that, and I didn't want to be on the bottom. I wanted them to see that on Dover Fire Department, on the Rollinsford Fire Department head on paper, that this is the change, just to follow up. All the area mutual aid companies that are our initial are all taken care of. Your question was with South Berwick. South Berwick has Nick Hamel, who's an employee of two-way communications, so they were done before.
Well, that's convenient.
Yeah. And I kind of get them, well, why don't you come over here and help us out? Say it was $450 a whack, but I haven't gotten that yet.
So, we have, in our minutes, we had an arrangement with two-way communication.
It's in the minutes that we took when we had meetings at the fire
station. Okay.
Yeah, so it was in there, and they just dropped the ball.
Okay, so we're getting a discount on
that I can't.
On the police being switched over, can we just sign the purchase order? If they were supposed to have done it at the same time, I imagine it would have been less expensive than them coming back.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure. I don't know what the purchase order was for, but it's typically in the $400 range. Ours is more money because they have to do pagers. And that's where it's become the issue with us, because we had all the engines, all the mobiles and the engines and the vehicles taken care of, all the portables taken care of, and our pagers taken care of. The trouble is with our pagers, is every member has one. Some of them are so old, they can't be reprogrammed. So I have about 6 or 7 of them, which are no good no more. Mm-hmm. So I'm in the process of trying to find the best price for us to upgrade our pagers. Because I had one of the oldest ones that they had, and it was fine with me, and it'd been working for 37 years, and now they can't do anything. Someone else on my bed stand, I woke me up every night. Now I'm kind of in a limbo. I mean, for 2 days, none of us had the ability to get, I had to use my portable radio and listen to every other community in the world going out to make sure we weren't missing. Some of those gaps have been closed, but it's just been a rather large mess, and it's starting to get a little better after a week's time, but there's still some issues. And we're just going to address them as they come up. But like I said, tonight we're going back over all our personnel as far as pagers go. But instead of paying the $400 or whatever it is for the reprogramming fee, it's going to cost us as a fire department 3 or 4 times that, just because we have to upgrade equipment.
Can you give a copy of those minutes to Bob Chief Duchamp?
Sure.
And because his was up to 450, but that included the highway as well.
Yeah. Yeah,
so
they may come under. They may come under. Yeah, and I never said anything about highway, mm-hmm. but it was mentioned that PD has to be addressed mm-hmm. also. But after that happened, it was just tough to get hold of him too. It's a nightmare trying. I don't know if he has any better luck, but it's a nightmare with us trying to get a hold of him. Yet. We don't even try. We go to Nick Hamel and go around left end. So
where are they headquartered?
Newington.
Right across the mall.
I mean, they did well with our setting up our engine, setting up the command vehicle. They did a nice job with all that. But this right here has been a little bit of a nightmare.
Denise, are you aware of the backstory of what happened and what put us in this situation? I can't remember if we mentioned it to you. So, Dover has had a project to upgrade all of their communications, et cetera, et cetera. And it was not going to have any kind of an impact on us. And then at the very end, like December or something, they said, what I call scope creep, you know, the project all of a sudden, oh, let's do this. This is Dover now, not us. Let's do this. Well, that doing this was going to cause us to either have to upgrade to digital, which is like tens and tens of thousands, mm-hmm. or maintain analog on a cell tower, on a tower somewhere. I don't remember which one.
Yes.
Thank you. And so I chatted with Chief Colarusso and said, and he said, we're really sorry, you know, we're very sorry. I said, well, you know, Chief, here's the story. Whatever it was, we're too close to town meeting. We can't put in a warrant article. The budgets are already done. And so he said, we can give you a payment schedule. So So we'll, next year when we do the budgeting, we'll have to put an additional of like 5,000 or something in the budget under the communication or
what
dispatch.
What was the total cost to us?
It was less, we thought it was going to be 15, it turned out to be like 11,000. So across 3 years, something like that.
And it didn't even come under this year's budget, that just starts on next year, right?
Next year starts on next year.
3 years running, yeah. Because we were originally trying to piggyback on the digital side of that, but it would have been $72,000. I don't think anybody wanted to deal with that. So we stayed on the analog side of things. And it actually works better for the town as a whole, because once the repeater or the antenna or whatever gets put up on the water tank to help with the local channel, that's still going to be analog, so that will help with the whole system. And that's coming this summer, from what my understanding is. So we stayed on the analog side. And actually, with it, we had one on Garrison Tower years ago when Jimmy Andrews used to take care of the radios. And then he sold out all his rights, and with that went the swan on the tower. But that is being full circle and back. So our analog repeater sits on the tower there now, and enhanced our radio capabilities immensely. We can talk down on the hole down there, which we didn't do before.
Right.
So, and then once we get the other one up here on the town side, local's going to improve, our radio communication should be, you know, well above. The issue with that is, it's still analog. Mm-hmm. And analog's probably got another service life of 10 years, and it's going to go away anyway. Mm-hmm. So that's something down the road to talk about strategic planning.
Well, I think,
and
the CIP. So I think when the CIP, and Denise is going to be managing the CIP process on our behalf this year. So so that's something that I think we'll need to
just, you know, down the road, for some, you know, under a capital line, or however, solve it away.
Yeah, communication, and it would cover you, police, highway, would just be comprehensive, I think.
Yeah.
George is here.
Chief Duchamp.
He's gone.
He left.
Well, I was going to ask him, because he was the one that precipitated a lot of this and sent me around an unappreciative email. I was going to have a discussion. It's okay. Because he says, well, how come nobody thought about us? Well, you were thought about it. But my thing is, PD can listen on Dover Fire, know when we were going places, but they didn't have any reason to talk to Dover. Just more of a monitoring thing, so they could follow us or know we were going out or whatever. And then he says, well, we have no way to communicate, and that's where he's wrong on that side, because we always have local. And whenever we have an incident, and George obviously knows about it when we have large incidents. What do we have large incidents, George?
We're all local.
We all go local.
So you didn't lose local?
No.
Okay.
This did not affect that at all, because that's our own town frequency.
Right. Right.
And then whenever we have an incident where it's, you know, storm related, which is what most of this happens, between the highway department, fire, and the police, we all play on local. Mm-hmm. And we can all talk to each other, and it works very well. That never got affected at all.
Okay.
So if they were monitoring local, a lot of times now when we go out on fire and things, we switch to local, especially when Dover was busy.
Right.
And that's one thing that's actually very good with this, is we don't have to do that anymore because we're on a shared frequency. Once we get toned out, they stay on theirs, we stay on ours. Mm-hmm. And it has more capabilities than switching to the local side of things. Mm-hmm. So.
Well, it sounds like everything gets straightened out.
It was a little glitchy.
And it was not of your asking, and you know, because Dover did this to all of us.
Oh,
but,
that's the other
thing.
Yeah.
But thank you.
I rebutted his email. And this is the fifth time in 6 years that the fire department, within our budget, has had to reprogram radios with changes not initiated by Rollins Fire Department. The last few years, South Berwick has changed, Rochester has changed, Berwick has changed, and every time somebody changes, find $450 because you have to do it. You have no choice. And that's this. We haven't asked for any of this stuff, so it just happens. So that's where some of that line item stuff gets kind of sucked away. And like I said, you know, ours is long gone, but we're going to find a bunch more pagers, but we'll find it.
Well,
we'll
for Caroline and Chief Ducharme, and just, you know, the 450 has to come out of somewhere, so sort of figure it out.
Well, that's it. He asked me to pay for his thing. I said, well, I'm more than willing to, because he had, I don't know, what year was it, Caroline, when he did it? He did it, I don't know, 08 or something like that, and he paid for everybody, but the PD initiated it. I said, that's fine. If I had initiated, I'd be more than willing to pay for your fee, but I didn't. done this year.
You're reacting yourself.
I got kicked to the curb and have to make it work.
Unless the board has an objection, we'll just leave it to you and Carolyn and Chief Ducharme to figure out.
It's all fixed, it's all taken care of. Just wanted to make sure everybody was on the same page.
We're good, thank you.
See ya.
And thank you for the quarterly report.
Do you need copy, Mark?
Mark doesn't.
It finds its way to me through Caroline.
Got it, okay.
Those guys said I handed it that way.
It's only Chief Ducharme that gets the whole thing back, is that correct? He likes the whole thing.
He likes this whole thing.
I don't know why, but everybody else, what do we just keep it in the folder, we sign it?
And then I distribute.
Okay.
I've lived for 6 years, I'm happy with it, so I'm not gonna upset that.
Works, we just need our new board member to, you know, because I don't know, so thankfully Caroline is here, so Ducharme gets his, the rest all go in the folder.
George sometimes takes his too.
Oh.
He doesn't have the invoice yet, right? And if you haven't placed it on order yet, you usually take yours with you.
No, sometimes, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Anything else?
Okay.
We're good.
I just love that.
They're having a fire department associated meeting as we speak. And there, you may or may not see the signs out, but maybe the breakfast is Saturday. I know you've been asking me before about when we were gonna do that again. Provided you get enough equipment, commitment from enough members, then it will fly.
Okay.
And it'll be kind of like, I've had dozens of people ask me when we're going to do it because they love flying out on the fire truck. So it's an opportunity to fly. Well, there are Monday night.
Two little children would probably die,
You don't have to wait for a Saturday to get a pancake to come and look at it. You help buy it, so come look at it.
Paula Woolley's grandsons, I'm sure.
It's not my truck. It's the town's vehicle, so come anytime you want. Okay.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. George?
See ya. Take care.
Purchase order 1117 for Atlantic Recycling Equipment. Various pieces of steel for a few projects for $244.75.
Second. We're supposed to fix the plow. So.
Yeah, we've had a few things we needed to fix.
Right.
We've got a few extra pieces to make the magnetic plow. So.
Okay.
That's great. Any other questions or comments?
No.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Bill from air gas for welding gas that went over the $252.82 because of the hazardous material price to put on the end of it.
We'll purchase order number 1115 to air gas for 252.82.
Second.
And that's the answer, George.
I can't scratch. Sorry.
Mine, Michael.
You win.
All right.
This is really not a contest.
Okay.
All right. I will call a question. All those in favor say aye.
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 Number 1113 to industrialfansdirect.com for $219
and if I wasn't shipping on that too much.
It's okay.
For $219.40.
Second.
So I suspect that this will help with air quality in the, so.
When you're welding or whenever we're doing anything, the trucks are running in the building, there is no exhaust fans in that building, even in the bathroom, which we use.
Has this been noted on a joint loss management or like, I'm looking at Caroline, Caroline?
It was once upon a time and we got as far as getting it wired, but I'm not sure if we're talking about the same thing. There was a hood. You know, there was a location figured out to get a hood installed and that was sort of prep wired but not purchased and installed. So I don't know if that can hook up to that, but
yes.
That's the, yeah.
You're saying yes. So the reason I'm bringing it up is so that as we report on joint loss, on the joint loss management committee's work for the year, then
mm-hmm.
we
yeah.
would want to include
sure.
this as something that we've done to help employee safety.
You can't believe we built a highway barn and didn't put an exhaust fan in.
There's still not one in the bathroom.
All right. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you for pointing that out.
So with the next joint loss, if you can make a note to make when it's installed and let us know that that's in there. So we can put it in the minutes.
Yeah, absolutely.
And this was on the joint loss, is for the flammable storage cabinet.
I'm sorry, it's for the what?
Flammable storage cabinet.
And we put it in the budget.
Yeah,
so
for $549 plus shipping. I'm not sure if the shipping will be as many trucking.
So well let's just add 10% just as a saving grace.
Yeah, that may be they'll have to come by truck rate.
Okay.
And that way.
600.
Yeah, okay. So we'll
I'll move purchase order number 1114. You get all the other ones. I know there's no one else for me. Yes. This is it. So to Global Industrial Incorporated for $600.
Second.
You put in the 600.
So a question on it is it like a fireproof safe?
That's exactly what it is.
So it's a concrete fire
fireproof.
Really heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so you'll have some fragrance.
We have a metal cabinet that we keep a lot of the stuff in, but it's not fire rated.
Mm-hmm.
This will keep the highly flammable stuff. We can put paint, latex paints in the other ones,
mm-hmm.
just keep it under control.
Yeah.
So with joint loss, it has recommended this,
yeah.
and if you check the notes in the detailed budget,
mm-hmm.
it does say under equipment.
I'm sure our liability company is probably mentioned.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, do all department heads have? Do all departments have these fireproof fireproof storage?
The police bought one last year. I don't know about the fire department.
I mean, they have.
But again, I would suggest
too.
That we talk about it at joint loss.
Yeah,
and
Kevin is. I think Kevin is
yes.
chief heard on the joint loss.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I know we talked about it, but I don't remember him saying it.
Yeah, nothing mentioned on the fire department having one, but some of this stuff probably was on the trucks.
Well, that's true too.
That's so
true.
That would eliminate that chance.
Right. Any other comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
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 And I have one for tractor supply for a 6x10 utility trailer for the lawnmower that we have in the budget.
Grass doesn't grow under your feet, Mr. Gilmet.
What did you call it again? I'm sorry.
It's a utility trailer to put the lawnmower
oh,
on.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Right now they have to use the 20-foot
also,
construction
also
trailer.
In the budget.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this is for $13.99. Try to get these projects out of the way before we start projects.
Purchase order 1116, tractor supply for 6x10 utility trailer for $1,399.
Second.
Any shipping associated with that?
Nope.
Picking that
I'll
up
just have to get probably a check right up there.
Okay.
You know, right
well,
the,
with the purchase order, Caroline will be able to write you a check.
Wherever
they have it in
the
stock,
is what
you're
yeah, they have it in
stock.
Stock.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they can't pick out which one until I get up there, so they can give me the numbers and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And
all right.
No charge for that, because they don't give you a 20-day plate, so we'll just take one of our plates up with it.
That's right, give you a plate. All right, all those in favor say aye.
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 I don't give you a temporary plate. Take it home.
They don't want to get involved with that stuff.
Well, fair enough, I guess, but...
Well, they charge you for it, they did.
True. Right.
Yeah.
So, I can get the bin and register first, or I'll just take one of my government plates up, and I'm sure they won't bother us anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So, in as far as purchases.
Okay.
I have heard back from Chris on Pike, so we have to go into it.
Okay. I'll move that we go into non-public. Are you ready for that? I'll move that we go into non-public session to deal with a contractual issue.
A second.
Roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Susan? All right, so there was no action to come out of tonight's non-public. Some things the board will take under advisement, and we may be seeing something next week that would be public. So that's the result of that. So George, last week you asked us about a possible summer schedule, and I think we thought we were just going to think about it. I don't think we actually did anything. So we can, if the board wants to say it's okay or not okay, but I did. So, you know, the sort of, you were suggesting 6 to 4, that's an exact 10 hours, and there needs to be a half hour for lunch.
Okay, 4:30.
Okay, so, and the same is true for your current schedule. So I don't know that it's posted anywhere, but it should include a half hour for lunch, just to, so OSHA or whoever.
We prefer not to get pinched by the Department of Labor. So
yes.
Well, we can change.
Please take a lunch.
Yes. And we have a Department of Labor supervisor who lives in town, so she will sometimes remind us about
breaks.
That's not at all.
Take your break, please.
Okay, so you're proposing Monday through Thursday.
And that can be changed if we have a project or something that we can swap the date.
Well, my assumption is that you're going to absolutely be responsible, and if there are emergencies or things that come up, I mean, that this would just be.
It won't incur overtime by moving a day.
Right.
You know, is what I'm saying.
This would be just a regular, assuming that nothing extraordinary is happening going on.
No, I mean, if there was a project that they needed us around, we could move a day.
Yeah, and again, it could be for, you know, if we had a contractor in, that maybe if we required someone, so. But those things we can work out as they happen, right? So.
And I was proposing May 1st to October 1st.
May 1st to October 1st? Is there anything, does that seem?
Do you want me to make a motion?
Yeah, I would entertain a motion to go on the summer schedule.
I'll make a motion to have the highway department go on to schedule, just the two of you, right? I'm sorry.
That's the highway department.
That's just there, okay. The highway department go on 4 days.
Nothing to do with the transfer station on that.
4 day schedule of 10 and a half hour increments from, what did you say?
May 1st.
May 1st
to October 1st. Okay. Mike?
Is there a second?
Second, I'm sorry, okay.
All right.
So the advantage, George, is that with 10 hour days, if you're working on a project, you don't have to, stop and.
Yeah, accomplish it more time to finish up something for the day.
What it does, by the time you set up and, you know, with your signage and all that stuff, if you get on a project and you can just stay with it. We've always found that we get more done in a 10 hour day in Berwick. I mean, I don't like to keep bringing it up, but.
Well, it's not uncommon to do something like that.
And most of your highway departments around here are doing it.
Yeah, I mean, it's good for employee morale, because it does give you a long weekend. And that's it's summer.
You don't get many of them in the winter.
Yeah, exactly, so. So, I mean, I think that's part of it.
But, no, it was, I mean, when we get going on a project, it's a lot easier to stay with it.
And this is what the practice was over in Berwick, you said?
Yep.
And working.
Not with everybody, I mean. And I was going out looking when I was pushing my grade thing.
Yeah.
Every highway department, I had Friday off, so I went to the highway department, although nobody was around.
Oh, I see.
Most places were closed, so, you know.
Right, right.
Some do it year round, but I wouldn't even recommend that year round, because that becomes.
Right.
Overtime nightmare.
I would imagine, yeah. Especially, yeah.
So.
No, I'm fine with that.
But, anything for me besides?
No, we haven't voted yet, So you did second it though, right?
Yes.
All right, so I'm ready to call the question. All those in favor of adopting a summer schedule for the highway department for May 1st, October 1st, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right, so you can carry that back to Ed. And I don't think we have to, you know, we may put an announcement on the website, we may not.
That probably wouldn't be a bad idea.
Probably.
So, could you take care of that, Caroline? I don't know. I suppose we can do it now, we don't need to wait.
Yeah, just give them a heads up that's happening.
Yeah, because that's always good to know.
And the truck is ordered.
Okay.
And 4 weeks before they have everything, so I told them I'll inspect it when I get back.
Okay.
And the radio stuff, you're going to get yourself included? No, I mean the frequency thing that we talked about with Chief Ducharme and...
Right,
so you're going to make sure that you're included with all of that, okay. All right.
Yeah, and we have the radio for the truck already, because he gave us an extra. We got two radios extra right now, so.
That's excellent.
Awesome.
All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, Drew. If we don't see you before your vacay, have a wonderful time.
Oh, I'm sure you'll probably see
me probably.
Good night,
he's not that long. Have a good night.
Are
we well-bearing it?
Yes, please.
All right, I'm going to go to non-public session for the purpose of hearing.
Can I?
Well-bear petitions. I'll retract that motion.
Yeah, just, I'm sorry, Mike.
Okay.
So I just want everybody to know, I think what we're going to do, just so everybody knows, is Michael is going to repeat that what he just did. So we're going to go into non-public, presumably, for welfare. We're going to, when we come out of that, I'm going to propose to Michael that he go in again for a personnel issue with Caroline. So I just want...
Come in and out now.
We'll come in and out, but we're not going to open the...
But you can't come in and out and do it just once?
I think for different purposes,
you have to separate.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we think that's the appropriate thing to do. But we don't want everybody to come in and then just look at
the door closed.
We'll do it with the door closed, yes.
I can say it louder.
Right. And we'll tell Salma when
we know the time for it.
Okay.
All right, so, thank you.
No worries. I should just jump in. All right, I'll move that we go into non-public session for the purposes of hearing welfare petitions.
Second.
All right, we'll do a roll call on that. Michael,
yes.
Okay, Denise?
Yes.
Suzanne, yes. Before you do that, look, can I do a little bookkeeping with Salma for a minute? So Salma, we came out of our non-public on the first, on the welfare at 8:13. And Michael is about to make a motion on that, and there was no action on the second non-public personnel.
Okay. Welfare this evening, the select board is recommending in case 2015-026. $325 in heating assistance, and in case 2018-002, $1,500 in rental assistance.
That was a motion.
Second.
All right, any questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
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 Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline.
Thank you.
Thank you. You too. My machine will come up, I will. All right, so we are in town administration, post-meeting chores, employee appointments, hourly rates, police. We've taken care of that. Committee appointments. So ZBA, we got two resignations. So Howard Hammond, I believe, right before the meeting, sent his resignation.
Tonight?
Yes, and Ron Shabbat, which I
was that.
Yeah. So we have two alternates. So we can check in. I can check in with the alternates and see if they would serve as full, and we can put out another notice.
Okay.
Did we have any reply from Joe?
No. I think this is probably a reply from Joe. I'm just, you know.
Oh, okay.
Change is difficult. You know, it changes really hard. I understand that.
Okay.
So I will check in with those two, and let me just make a note if you don't mind here.
So they both have said they wanted to be reappointed.
No. Joe recommended that they do. Actually, Ron was in a position. He was in a term. He was in a. He was.
He wasn't up.
He wasn't up. Right.
Okay. There's another thing we need to review with membership and stuff, and that's the collection of chairs. Let me just finish my note here. Okay, so with regard to, you know, commissions, boards, whatnot, the first order of business is to elect a chair, right? And, you know, they haven't. This board wasn't doing that when I first came on. I mean, we've been a lot more respectful of the fact that, you know, one shouldn't assume that one is going to continue.
Mm-hmm.
And the same is true of our other boards and commissions. And so in the letter that we sent out, we said for the ZBA, I said that the board would call the first meeting and preside until a chair was elected.
Right.
So I think right now we have to make sure we have a full board, so we'll check in with the alternates and that sort of thing. For the planning board, you are the ex officio, so I would assume that you would preside at the first meeting and tell them they would then
That will be in May, but we don't have a meeting in April.
Yes, yes. Which is that, are you supposed to meet every month?
I think so.
So maybe you could have a conversation with the board about that, and that I think you just call a recess if you're not going to have a, something like that in the I also sent the ZBA folks and the planning board folks the handbook that the state provides.
Perfect, thank you.
Planning boards and ZBAs. So just, you know, for so that everybody knows what their statutory responsibilities
are. So I'm sorry, you're saying an email to the members of the planning board?
No, just when you, well, you can if you want, but at the next meeting, you just say, so the first order of business customarily for our first meeting of the new year is to make sure that, yeah. And you can tell Miles ahead of time and so that he's not taking
Okay, so Wednesday, I'll be presiding at the beginning and take the vote for the budget committee because I'm ex officio you.
I didn't say that for the budget committee that's elected. These are the committees and boards that we appoint.
Okay.
I do agree that that's what we should do.
Well, I'll ask Michelle if she wants me to do that, and then we'll make the vote for the chair, and then the chair can take it off and do the remaining.
Yes.
Okay, I'll check with her.
I'll check with her. I mean, because there was a big to-do when I was ready to preside one night, and, and there was a big to-do.
That's how it always was when I was on it.
It's
3 years, that's what happened.
You know, and they refer back to the guidelines, but the fact of the matter is the guidelines don't pertain to the new board.
Right.
You have to readopt them, right?
Yes.
They have to adopt them.
Yeah, they don't hold.
Gotcha.
Even if they say, here's what's going to happen next year, it doesn't hold. All right, so we'll wait for the ZBA until we get a better idea that we have a fully constituted board. And the Conservation Commission, we should do the same with them. So I'm happy to do that. If one of the rest of you wants to call that first meeting with the Conservation,
all yours.
You can have it.
All right. It won't be right away, but maybe I'll just get it in motion.
Okay.
But I'm going to be gone for a couple of days, so.
Well, if you need it done, if you're going to be away, I can do it.
Well, I'm not. I won't be away for the meeting. It's just the getting in touch. I think otherwise, so you're ex officio and historical, and you're on the rec, so, and they may have done it themselves, I don't know, and that would sort of be okay too, but we should make sure that at the first meeting, they elect a chair. Yeah.
We haven't met since then. We're meeting tomorrow night, actually, so we'll bring it up tomorrow night.
Yeah, rec is, they didn't vote for their chair, so I won't bring it up.
Yeah, just as a matter, just so we get good practice.
Yep.
We build a good process. All right, management response. On the table, I don't have any draft to show you. Training. So I'm really sorry, Mike. We've got a tentative municipal budget process training.
That's why I tried to tell you that.
I know.
Meeting when I was
and that, you know what I remembered? I remembered that was a day that you could make.
No, that's a day. I will be traveling that day.
Yes.
West.
So,
what is this that we're talking about?
Enjoy your trip.
This training.
We'll have a book for you.
The book will be fine.
So what I wondered about, and I'm asking the board, is so clearly we'll be inviting the budget committee, and Michelle's going to talk about it at the first meeting, and the select board. But you know, we could also, we talked about not wanting to make it open to people outside our community.
Mm-hmm.
We could also publicize it on our website and say someone is interested in running for budget committee someday, this would be a good time to learn what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And we would just ask them to call Caroline to, just because I doubt that we're going to get like 20 people.
Right, right.
But we should, in case we have to change the venue, we should just know. So how does the board feel about that?
I'm okay with
opening it up to.
I'll be drinking Mai Tais. You can do whatever you want. No, I'm just trying not to do it. So, I think it should be open to the townspeople for sure. I would just caution you that the meeting is for the elected members of the budget committee and the elected members of the select board.
Yes, and we could.
So they should be separated.
Yeah, we could say that in the little blurb that goes out, and we can say it at the training session as well.
So they really shouldn't be participating in the...
Correct.
Unless they're important, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
For sure.
That's exactly what it...
Oh, yeah, of course.
So...
So this is a night meeting?
It would be at 6:30.
At 6:30 here?
Right now, yes.
Okay.
I can't imagine if you would get a bigger room, but you never know.
You know, it's still tentative. I said we'd get back in touch with the municipal association after the meeting of Wednesday. So...
I'll text you from one. Enjoy your training.
So, and then tentatively, the town would do, the quarterly review would be the week following. So this would give the, you know, everybody the sort of, hear the same thing before we actually start official review process.
Should we invite the department heads as well to understand the budget?
It's a good idea.
Fire, police, highway?
Sure.
It's a winning idea.
Library?
Great idea.
Yes.
That would be a very good idea.
Well, it's the board is meeting. That's just the...
What?
I'm not supposed to say anything.
I'm going to get the notes.
Exactly.
I know.
Okey-dokey.
Sorry about that. Just trying to be, you know, trying to hold a good meeting. So we'll invite department heads.
Yep.
General, the town, but... the way people do at our meetings, you know, as non-participants.
Yeah, what I would suggest is you set up a table for the select board members, for budget committee members, and then if there's room, maybe the department heads, but I would think maybe the department would be sitting.
Yeah, I thought we could just sort of, you know, like a little seminar, you know, do tables like this, the point that way, and then just chairs in the background. So the people who are like
Right, that's what I was going to say. Yeah. So a table set up like this and that.
Yes, for the folks that were participating.
Yes. Yeah.
And then that way, also the Municipal Association will be able to see as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
My apologies.
Yes, I'm really sorry. So MapGeo, MapGeo is what we subscribe to that has the information on the town and the tax and stuff. And they're coming, it's Tuesday.
Is that Tuesday?
Where is MapGeo?
I don't have it online.
Oh, yeah. I added a couple things. I'm so sorry.
Okay.
So sorry. On April 10th, so that's a week from tomorrow, at 6:30 here, Rachel Mack from SRPC is giving a demo on MapGeo, which is this tax card and other layers. And so I would like to invite the Conservation Commission, the Zoning Board, and the Planning Board in particular, and then, of course, the general public.
I don't think I'm available for the 10th. I'm out of town.
Well, we set this like weeks and weeks ago.
You can, but I've had a meeting on my calendar for weeks and weeks and weeks, so forward. Or something.
It was with the... So I'm just...
You're
we didn't select you...
Zoning,
Planning, and Conservation Commission.
Conservation.
We didn't slide you. I mean, we set this back in December, I think. Yeah, something like that. So, all right. So so I'll send that particular invitation to Conservation, Zoning, and all right, and then the general public.
Okay.
Is it the same presentation they gave when they were selling it to us?
I don't know.
But with Rollinsford information now, or?
We do have Rollinsford information. I really don't know. She said she did it at Northwood, and they thought it was helpful.
Okay.
So that's all I can say. I don't really know.
And what was her name, Rachel?
Her name is Rachel, but it's spelled R-A-C-H-A-E-L, Mack, M-A-C-K. All right, we've done interdepartmental radio communication. Oh, ordinances.
Yep.
Oh, this was a pleasant experience.
I knew there was. We had one.
You were right. But Michael.
Is it that not exist anywhere?
Pretty much, almost.
Somewhere.
So, it doesn't surprise me that it's not on our website because we only have the most recent ones and we haven't finished the process. Our town clerk couldn't find it, but that's the third step. The second step was I looked up, the police have a link to ordinances on their website. Mm-hmm. It's not there.
Well, I read it somewhere.
It's not there. So I asked Chief Ducharme, I said, well, you must have, because he was saying, I said, you must have a printed copy that you're looking at. And so he brought it up. Kate finally did find something in her second binder.
Okay.
And it's called Peddlers and Hawkers.
Yeah, two binders of...
Yeah, but she didn't find it right away. It was not obvious, so she did, but she did find it. So I haven't read it, but there is no permit. And so I think what we should do is maybe put something on the town website that says that people need, somebody has to look at the ordinance to phrase this, but mm-hmm. you need a permit in order to go door to door. I guess that's what it's saying. And therefore, you should feel free not to answer your door or call the police or mm-hmm. whatever. I don't know what the appropriate thing is, but we could do something like that.
Yeah, I mean, I wonder if the ordinance is even constitutional. But,
because you can't stop a door-to-door salesman.
Right. I
wondered about that myself. I mean, that's why I thought there wasn't one, because
right.
how can you stop somebody from trying to sell something?
I don't know. You're gonna harass the
Girl
Scouts.
But they should at least notify
Girl Scouts.
Right.
Somebody that they're going to.
We don't stop them, I think. We just ask them for a permit. I don't think there's any charge.
I was going to say, but then at least then you can put on it that you may be seeing
right.
this company in town,
right.
you know.
So the problem
I
is
think it's
folks
scary
understand.
Knowing that.
Comcast allegedly was going door to door, knocking on people's doors
yeah.
to sign them up.
I didn't hear it back. You saw that I sent mail to Jay Summers.
Yeah, I think it's interesting that a multi-billion-dollar company is
going door
to door. Door
yep.
But that's why I thought it was pretty sketchy.
Well,
but
they don't.
It was pretty sketchy. But anyways.
And they don't cost.
They had to register with the town to do it. So.
There's no one registered currently.
Yeah.
He did say that. And so what
do you want
to do that?
I remember reading it. I mean, it's for like itinerant peddlers.
I don't know what it says. I don't have a
It wasn't problem. Like, I think, Girl Scouts selling cookies probably don't rise to the level, but I'm trying to remember what they
would,
I don't have a front of
you,
but
would
I remember
you,
reading
what if you like to read it and
sure.
we can hold off on a week,
sure.
Hold off a week before you do anything?
Yeah.
So we have scanned it. So it should.
Okay.
So ask Caroline, or I may have it. So
okay.
we, either Caroline or I will send you the.
Yeah, I'm happy to take a look at it. And, I mean, we should probably do a review of our ordinances again yearly, anyways, and then.
Well, we should get them all online in
right.
one spot.
Right, right, right. No, I agree with you.
That's what we should do.
They should be.
You know, Chief
Ducharme
said. I said, it's embarrassing. And he says, well, you're not expected to know all of the ordinances. That's not what I'm embarrassed about. He said that we don't have them all in one place.
Yeah.
Not that I don't know everything that's in there. I don't. That's not the issue. The issue is that I didn't know this was an ordinance. The places that I knew to look, I don't see it.
You know, the only reason I know this is back when I first got on, we were dealing with an ATV ordinance.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the same binder. It's on onion skin, I believe, to be honest with you.
Onion
skin paper.
No. That one was. No, it
well,
was
well,
back to 2010.
In that binder.
It was back to 2010.
It's in the binder full of onion skin ordinances. It may not have been on it.
I'm sorry.
It's like the whole binder, and then there was other stuff, so it was sort of tacked in. I'm not surprised that it wasn't scanned, to be honest with you.
Well,
I
thought it was because it was fairly recent, because actually most of the onion skin is in the first binder, I thought,
yeah.
really old stuff.
Yeah.
And this was some of the newer stuff, but,
yeah.
The lesson is that, we still, and we know that. I mean, if you look on our ordinance, and there's a readme somewhere that says, we're in the process of getting our ordinances up here, but they're not all here. And when we do, when they are here, all there, then, when I talk to Chief Ducharme about this, his link will then just point to ours, so there will just be one copy. We'll still need the printed copy for the town clerk. I mean, that's just, until the state does something different, that will always be a requirement. But that's okay, as long as the online is, it has everything that it needs to be. All right, so Mike, I'll have Caroline send you a copy of that.
Happy to.
Tabling the SRPC grant possibility.
Yeah, because not on my
Anything you want to, yeah, that, no, that is there.
Oh, has, sorry.
H7, whatever that's. Michael, anything, any updates on the SB?
The hearing, I signed this in, I couldn't stay, I had a hearing for work, I had to be at Dunn Hall, so. And I haven't run into Cordell Johnson or, can't think of her name, Silva.
Oh, Judy.
Judy, thank you. In the hallways today, so if I see them tomorrow, I'll ask them for an update, and I can give you one next week, I didn't go to the hearing.
All right, the initial conversation is just there, you know, so that if there's something to add, but we're tabling for tonight unless somebody wants to say something. Oak Street Boundary, Michael, I'm gonna find, you haven't done anything, I'm gonna find the information we have from Kevin on what we needed to do.
Okay.
And maybe either you could do it alone, or maybe the two of us could do it, unless Denise would really like to perambulate and walk the.
The border.
Border.
No, thank you.
I want to, I'm excited to do it.
Yeah, so if in fact it just requires one of us, are you okay with you being the one?
Sure.
Okay, so I'm gonna make a note, it'll be a few days, because I'm going away for a couple of days. I thought you might enjoy this. It's an old colonial, dates back to colonial times.
Do it.
Okay.
That would be good.
Okay. Right, town administration.
Yes.
Okay, so under board member and activities, the April 23rd meeting, that is there because I will not be here. Good. Denise, will you be here?
I will be here.
Okay, so the two of you are, you won't be here?
I won't be here, but I will be here that week.
Okay, so you won't be here on the 30th?
The 30th, but that's Memorial Day, isn't it?
No.
Oh, April, oh, good lord.
Michael?
Only a month off.
Yes.
That's May 30th.
Yes.
Sorry.
It's okay. All right, so otherwise, what activities and updates are going on for us this week?
Historic committee's meeting tomorrow night, and then, it's a couple of weeks early, but I'll get it on the calendar now. April 22nd, the historic committee is hosting a walk, another walk, this time a village walk with Peter Michaud.
Will it be on the webs, it'll be, oh, that's great.
It's a guided walk of the village.
What day of the week is that?
Sunday, I believe it's, if I get the right month this time. It is at 2:00.
All right, excellent. Denise?
I'll be doing budget meeting at 6:30 on the 4th, Wednesday, covering for you.
Yes, thank you so much.
And that is all I have.
All right. All right, that's it for activities and updates. I did go to Cynthia Copeland's retirement last Thursday, and I thought there was something from that I wanted to tell the board, and now I completely forgot it. I don't think, she talked to us about the road audit, so it wasn't that. It was about road surface.
Culverts?
Nope. I think she said something, I don't know, so it'll come, it'll come back to me at 1:00.
About 2:00 in the morning.
Yeah, probably.
Right.
If I want to call.
At 5:00 in the morning, but I will not. Okay, are we ready for building permits?
Yes.
First one we have is 2018-004, 459 Stockdale Circle. They are putting up a garage with, and adding on to their master bedroom, apparently kind of bump into it, the top of the garage. Mr. Clark has reviewed it, it's a $475 fee. Schematics on there. Next one we have is building permit 2018-021, 457 Prospect Street. They are putting up a shed slash pool house and erecting a small above ground pool and putting a small deck on the small pool. The fee is $75.
Is there fencing around that pool?
Mm-hmm. It's above ground, it doesn't have to.
It's above ground, I don't know how they would see.
I not necessary?
I don't know.
I don't think it is from above ground, only in ground, I think.
I don't think you can stumble into an above ground, well, maybe you can from the deck, but. There appears as, I don't know, let's see, I don't know. Deck for pool. There's a fence around the side of the deck. I'd go this way into the. Doesn't say. There isn't one on the. On
okay. The, well, you could well be right. He doesn't need one. It was just a question.
Mine didn't.
Well, so it's actually okay. So probably not. Saying it's not attached to the house. So it's like, it's a ways from the house. There's a little set of stairs that goes up to the above ground pool. And so probably not.
All right.
There would be a fence on like this side of the deck. I can't imagine they would need a, mm-hmm. I don't know
Tom,
how you would.
Tom would have,
yes.
He would know, right? So he didn't mention it, so he must be there. I'm good.
It's not an in ground pool. I don't know. Anyway. It's for the in-ground, you don't fall into it, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. I think you'd have to be 8 feet tall to fall into this one. So.
Well, there are things like attractive nuisance, though, nonetheless. They need to
for sure.
Mm-hmm. Right, so, but,
for sure. Okay, permit number 2018-022. Two, I think that's 216. How could two be? Or that I crossed out to?
I think it's
216 Summersworth
so.
Road. They're constructing a new house on the lot where the house was torn down. So park there where
on the lot where the house was torn down.
That was
mm-hmm.
used
yeah.
to be.
Was that the one that had the fire?
Yes.
Yes.
I believe so. When it was half it was torn down, but as I recall. There were issues. This
were
is
there
the same problem. Yes, there was issues with.
Mama.
Issues with the site where they had to build in the same exact footprint. Blah blah blah. Let's see. Mm-hmm. If that's the one.
Ray Brown's house was right.
I don't know.
Say that one more time, please.
Ray Brown's house. It's right in front of where they have that sand pit.
Yeah.
Behind.
Yeah.
It's in the back of it.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, because
so do we want to ask Tom a question?
Yeah.
Before we sign it?
I do, actually.
We have, maybe we could put up your post-its?
Sure. Here, pick it.
I'll take the big, the biggest one. I'm gonna take the biggest one.
Okay.
Oh.
Maybe they're not okay.
Well, they are. They're not
new. They're not new, for sure. Thank you. Are there restrictions on this law? Because the original, this saga has been going on since my very first meeting, I think, or second meeting, with this lot. It was here. And there was issues with the available footprint to build on in this.
Because
this,
of wetlands, I think, was
wetlands.
The
mm-hmm. Yeah, so we need to, make
did you mention wetlands?
As for other restrictions on this lot. Let's see. Tom may very well have already taken that into account, so, but, okay, and the last one, I guess, is permit 2018-023, 494 Silver Street. They are taking out a kitchen from upstairs, cap and drain and pull down water line. That must have been, I don't know, must have been an apartment out there. So it's demolition within the existing structure. The fee is $35. Alteration, if you want to call it that. more time?
That's the one that's up for sale.
On Silver Street?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Was it like a two-family?
It was at one time, and now it's only a single-family.
Well, that's why they're taking out that upstairs.
Probably.
That makes sense then.
Yeah.
That's right. Why are they taking out the upstairs kitchen? Didn't make any sense. Now it makes sense.
Two-family one, and then when they bought it, they made it
converting it to one family.
Mm-hmm.
That
but
makes
now
sense.
It's up for sale again.
Oh. Well.
Okay. Denise, anything in your folder?
My pal. Notice of public hearing, the City of Rochester. I hereby notified of a public hearing Wednesday, April 11th at City Hall. Motion to rehear filed by a coalition on Meterboro Road abutters.
Why are we getting this?
Why would we get this?
Because I learned about why.
Oh,
not about this specific issue, but during the planning training there with Attorney Bradigan, if there are regional impacts on a project, than abutting towns within a certain mile radius.
So what would be the
should
regional
be notified.
Impact
I don't know. I don't know anything about
what
this.
What, GECO site and T-Mobile for construction of a wireless communication facility?
Oh, the towers. The towers do, and we've gotten hearings for towers on like Rye, so there must be a mileage requirement.
Mm-hmm.
But
so
like,
that's what that is for
the
T-Mobile.
Stuff over the old Sunningdale Country Club, our town was in a butter, but we got noticed because of that, because of all the
yes.
traffic, right, that we caused.
Yeah.
We don't have to say anything, but.
That's old. We did that. That was the warden.
Okay.
This was the Red Bridge, a report.
Red List.
Yeah, yeah, the Red List for the bridges, and we determined that both Oak Street and Mill Home, that's the last time, too.
Okay.
So how do we get rid of this stuff?
Somebody has to sit with Caroline
oh.
and, say, can you please take this out of there?
Oh, this is Municipal Assessing Services by Cochrane Consulting Associates. We don't need to do that, right? Because we're going to...
We get things from engineers.
Yeah.
We get things
so
from assessors.
Like
it's advertising. And
that's it.
All right. Community input? All right. Well, I'm ready to call it quits. Is the board ready to call it quits?
Yes.
All right. Excellent.